Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to the Trading Success Show, guys. Well, what do we have going on here? We have Dogecoin going on right here. Overall, I have a Doge. I've been calling Doge for a long time, even when it was at the pennies. And now we're just pushing higher and higher and higher. Beautiful. So, well, as of yesterday, Doge was actually trading around the 43 cents spot. And I called it for a push towards the 60 cents, which is the next part. 50 cents, 60 cents, which is the next part. And we got above 50 cents and then pulled back to retest that breakout spot. So now we have this trend, and this trend actually broke by holding this uptrend. Now, we gained momentum and Doge actually pushed higher to close to about 70 cents, which I call 70 cents, if you round that up. So pretty much we have another trend right now, and this uptrend and this downtrend, when they meet, that is where we define if we're gonna go higher or we're gonna go lower. Overall, I'm looking for this downtrend, this uptrend to actually hold. If we can hold this uptrend on Dogecoin, then we'll be able to break the 70 cents level. I'm waiting and I'm looking forward to the 70 cents break on Doge. Now, let's go ahead and look at the FIBS level where Doge is going to go today. Okay, this is a trading view. Or in trading view, we need to go into the tools they have, which is called the FIBS retracement. Okay, so now we have to plot this from the top of the candle, the highest candle, the peak, all the way to the bottom. Okay, so that is where we have it. Now, for us to determine where is the possible spot on Doge, using this, because when I did plot it earlier on, when we were around the 20 cents level, it gives me about 60 cents target. So we got to about 62 cents, okay, and then we broke out of the 62 cents spot. Okay, you see how, you know, FIBS is really solid, because all this move, we push back down to this spot here, 20 cents, and then we continue pushing higher and higher and broke out of this 60 cents, 62 cents level to retest these 60 cents. But when we got to the 60, 61 cents, we pull back again to test the 55, 54 cents to push higher again. So right now we are at the 70 cents. So this 70 cents is a form of a resistance. So what we're gonna do here in this case, we need some form of a pullback and then a push higher. Overall, I'm looking around the 85 cents and 85 cents and 90 cents for a continuation higher on Dogecoin. Okay, so if we can break this 85-90 cents, the next level of resistance is going to be right here around the $1 spot. That is where the FIBS is giving me. And then we continue pushing higher and higher on Doge. Overall, I'm looking for my first target of $1 on Dogecoin. But one thing you have to understand is Dogecoin is now the number 4 on the crypto exchange based on market cap. We have about $85 billion on the market cap on Doge. Okay, volume is coming in as 45 billion so far traded in the last 24 hours. And in circulation, we have 130 billion worth of Doge out there in circulation. Overall, the market cap is 85. If we can supersede the supply, I think there's a greater chance for Doge to just keep going higher and higher and higher. Okay, so that is the review for Doge, and that is what I want to see for Doge to hold this trend. It's okay for Doge to pull back over to this 62, 63 cents spot. That is fine for a continuation higher. which is what I call a healthy pullback. We need a healthy pullback for a continuation higher. Overall, I still have some of my core positions, and on other account I just keep taking some profit as we push higher. Overall, thank you guys. I appreciate you guys being here, and have a fantastic Doge week ahead. Bye bye.